Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the top five room size and volume mistakes. In audio rooms where you're producing energy, that's full frequency energy, low, middles, and highs, you have to select the right size and volume for the usage. I see too many times too small a room, too much energy, and treatment won't even help at that point. So we have put together a couple graphs and charts to help you with this, and we'll include those at the end of this video so you can kind of see the relationship between size and volume subwoofers, size and volume, and room usage. So obviously the first thing we have to consider in our smaller rooms today is this low frequency management. You know, subwoofer energy, low frequency generating devices all need volume. They need volume so that they can release their energy and that you can manage it correctly. If the room is too small, then you just add more room sound. So then you're fighting room sound and high pressure levels from the low frequency energy. So if you don't have the right room volume to deal with the amount of energy that you have, then you're kind of beat before you start, because treatment will not help in most cases. So volume is critical in low frequency management. Sidewall reflections, also very critical. We know at our monitoring and our listening position, it's always a balance between direct and reflected energy. So if our sidewalls are really close, then we have this, you know, primary, secondary, tertiary reflection points that are very close to each other. And, you know, managing that so that it balances between the direct energy from the speakers is always critical. So we need appropriate distances to work with. And I don't see those in a lot of times. In fact, a lot of times I see speakers right against the wall. I see speakers in the corners of rooms. And that's just wrong, completely wrong. So you don't want to do anything resembling that. We're trying to eliminate room sound, not increase it. Putting your speakers close to a boundary surface increases room sound by as much as 3, 4, 5, even 6 dB. So you have to be very, very careful. Here's another thing that we need to concentrate on, low frequency source positions. If you have good volume and you have good room size, the next step is to position your low frequency producing devices in the right position in the room. There is this place in all rooms where the low frequency generating device can actually be positioned correctly to make sure that the room response is smoother. Maybe if we choose this position for our subwoofer, we get this response. Maybe if we choose this position, we get a smoother response. So we get less of an energy problem that we have to create and treat. So there's different places in the room, depending on size and volume, where that low frequency energy device should be placed. Subwoofer is a good example that produces a smooth response curve. If you're having difficulty figuring that out, send me your room dimensions and I can help you. We have that information in our database. Here's another one that people constantly fight, especially here in North America: low ceiling height. Remember, you're sitting on the floor. So the reflections from your speaker, from the ceiling to you, and from the floor to you are the first ones that you receive. In North America, we have that dreaded 8-foot ceiling height, which is one of the worst dimensions in acoustics that you can have. So always try to get a volume and a size that allows for an appropriate ceiling height. What's ideal? 14 feet. I know it's high, but that's ideal acoustically because it's a nice balance between treatment and function. So try to get as high a ceiling height as you can. Stay away from 8-foot. High pressure levels. People are monitoring and listening at too high of pressure levels for their room size and volume. Your room has a certain break point, a certain Schroeder frequency, if you will, where the energy of the room and the energy of the system kind of balance each other out. And you have to make sure that you're not running 100 dB SPL in a closet, so to speak. So you have to match the listening pressure levels that you're using within the room size and volume. Low frequency management's a volume issue. Sidewall reflections, always a distance issue. Low frequency source positions within the room to smooth out the frequency response and then add treatment. Low ceiling height, stay away from 8-foot. because the ceiling and the floor reflections are the first ones we have to manage correctly and monitor and listen at proper levels that go with the room and keep everything in balance. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed our videos today, and if you did, we really would appreciate a thumbs up from you. If you have any questions or comments, you can go to the comment section, or you can go to our website, acousticfields.com, and fill out the contact form. Subscribe to our channel, our YouTube channel. We're now doing 2 videos a week. If you have some ideas for topics, you can submit those to us also. If you're having room issues, we have that free room analysis. You can click on the button below, and we'll compare your room to our database of 120 built rooms that we built and actually measured, and I guarantee you your room is in that database. So just click on the button below for the free room analysis. Thank you.